St. Charles Borromeo was a bishop, a cardinal, during the time of the Council of Trent. And the Council of Trent was trying to combat the Reformation. And really, the Council of Trent was trying to codify really how we live our Catholic Christian faith, because at that time, the church was a mess. The priests were not living the Christian life. Sisters, brothers weren't, lay people weren't. It was a real mess. And so Charles Borromeo reformed the church to say, if we're going to be a church, we gotta live the gospel. And he challenged his fellow bishops and cardinals. He said, you know, if we want the lay people to live the good Christian life, we gotta be the first examples. And so he said, we need to really reform ourselves. In the gospel today, Jesus challenges us to look how we follow him. We hear that word hate in the gospel, and when we hear it, we may almost bristle and say, we're not supposed to hate. But Jesus says, you know, hate your brother, and if you don't hate your brother and sister, you're doing okay. And so sometimes kids can say, yeah, I hate my brother, I hate my sister, I hate my mother, so they think maybe they're living the Christian life. But certainly that's the opposite. But what Jesus is saying, the word hate, it really means to choose one over the other. And basically, the Lord is saying, I, the Lord, must be the center of your life. Not your parents, not your children, not your own life. He says, I have to come first. Certainly, he doesn't denounce and downplay that we have to love our families, but rather he helps us to refocus where our focus needs to be, and that is on Jesus Christ. When we reform ourselves, sometimes we need to look at ourselves and say, am I really living the best I can as a Catholic Christian? And sometimes we put possessions or things or other people in the way of our relationship with the Lord. And the Lord tells us today, that can't be the way. You gotta let go and allow the Lord to be the center. And so today, as we celebrate the life of Charles Borromeo, the great reformer, let's ask the Lord to help us to reform, help us to place him center of our life. And as we hear in that first reading, we know that one day we will rejoice and share the joy with our Lord.